So the thinking is we're still in the third inning around regulatory change and impact on banks, and there's still several more requirements that need to be implemented, whether it be around liquidity, capital, or other requirements that impact consumers. In addition, the timeline people have predicted this could continue to as long as 2018, and therefore the comment around still in the third inning. So the intent of all the regulation is to make the banks more safe, have higher capital levels, and in addition, so that the consumers are not misled and harmed during sales practices, right through foreclosure practices. Having said that, there have been several unintended consequences of all the new regulation on banks. So one, right off the bat, which is probably one of the first, was the Durbin Amendment, which took as much as $20 billion out of the banking system as a result of reducing banks' fees on debit card transactions. And there was another $5 billion that was taken out of the banking system on an annual basis based on the need for customers to opt in to overdraft facilities. And I think a good way to describe the unintended consequence is a quote from a big bank CEO who said, if we can't charge for the French fries, we're going to charge more for the Coke. And that's exactly what's happened in banking. So as consumers, we all see, banks might be getting less fees from our debit card transactions, but in fact, there's no more free checking. You know, we all have to pay for monthly account fees or higher account balances and lots of other ancillary services that we in the past have enjoyed free of charge that banks are now charging us for. As a result of the onerous requirements on banks, there have been several businesses that have been exited. One, it just becomes too costly for the banks. Two, the return on capital is much lower. Or three, they're just simply prohibited from doing certain types of activities. And I think a good example of that is prop trading, where banks are now prohibited through the Volcker rule to do any of the trading on their own account. As a result, there's been what's called a shadow banking system that's been developed. And the risk with that is it's not regulated. So in effect, we're shifting these same risky activities to organizations that are not regulated, that are prepared or will take on more risk. And we potentially could end up in the same situation as 2008, albeit with a different set of players.